How to make your portable hotspot faster. This is an advanced tutorial, so make sure you watch the full video to benefit the most from it. What you're looking at right now is a diagram that is showing you what a typical wireless hotspot looks like. You have your hotspot, which could be a phone, and it's connected to the wireless network, which could be a 3G, 4G, or a 5G network. And on the right, you have the devices that are connected to the hotspot. So you have your PC, you have a mobile device, and then this box is to represent if there are any more devices connected to the same Wi-Fi hotspot. So that means that the reasons why your Wi-Fi hotspot might be slower could be either because the devices connected to the hotspot are slowing it down, but it could also be that the hotspot is slower, or because the network that you're connected to offers limited data speeds. If the network provides limited data speeds, what would mean is that even if you optimize the devices, you buy a new device, or you buy a new hotspot, it wouldn't make any kind of difference. However, there are certain settings that you can do to optimize the connection between network and hotspot. There are two things you can do to have a better data throughput between the network and the hotspot. What you'll need to do is you'll need to go into your settings and then select the SIM card which you're using for your data connection. And if you are on 4G network, disable Volt. Now, Volt is used to improve the quality of voice calls. However, if you're using just for data purposes the hotspot, it doesn't make sense to have it enabled. Now, this should improve your hotspot performance. And the second thing I recommend is in the network type, when you go, you should definitely try to have a speed test on both the LTE, which is 4G, and if you have a really slow performance, do try it on 3G network as well. In some cases, let's say in my case, I've noticed that 3G network has always performed a lot more faster than the 4G network. However, for some people, the 4G network is gonna be performing a lot more faster. Now, doing a speed test on your portable hotspot is pretty easy. Select whichever network you want to test. So let's say I want to test my 3G network speed. I'm gonna select that as the network type. And then I'm gonna go into Play Store and I'm gonna download this app called Fast Speed Test. Once I do that, I can open it. And as soon as I open it, it runs off the speed test straight away. So right now it's showing me the download speed, and it's gonna show me the latency as well in a few seconds. And there we go. So we have the latency. For me, it's about 278 ms right now. And now it's testing the upload speed as well. So let's see how much that is. So my upload speed on the 3G network is 2.1 Mbps, but it's not finalized yet, because it's still grayed out. So I'm gonna just wait till it darkens up like the rest of the text, and there we go. So now it's 1.8 Mbps, and that's my upload speed. Make sure to run the speed test on both 4G as well as 3G network. In case you have a 5G network, you should test that out as well. Now that the part between the network and the hotspot is covered, we're gonna cover on what could be the possible bottlenecks between the hotspot and the devices. What you'll need to do is go into your settings and then portable hotspot. It might be called wireless hotspot as well for some users. And you will see something called as setup portable hotspot, or it might be portable hotspot settings. Now, once you select that, you'll see an option called Select AP Band. Now in my case, it's set to 2.4 gigahertz, but it's gonna be a lot more faster if you have it set to 5.0 gigahertz band. Make sure that all your devices that are connecting to the hotspot support this frequency. Otherwise, you might notice that some devices, like really old devices, are not able to connect to the hotspot. In that case, it's up to you to decide if that device needs to connect to hotspot or not, or if you want to have accessibility for that device as well, you'll need to revert back to 2.4 gigahertz band. Now that your hotspot is optimized, the last step comes is optimizing the devices that are connected to the hotspot as well and understanding their limitations. So, for example, I have my tablet connected to the Wi-Fi network right now, and I'm gonna run a speed test to show you guys what speed I get. So on my tablet, I'm getting 75 Mbps. And my upload speed is still loading, so I'm gonna wait for that to finish. So the test finished at 110 upload speed. Now, my phone is connected to the Wi-Fi as well, and it's the same Wi-Fi. However, I'm getting a lot more speed. It's like three times more download speed as compared to my other device. So it's going 360 Mbps right now, 380, wow. Darkened up. And this is something like you should know because the devices are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. However, the download speed for the tablet is slower because it's a really old device, and that is a hardware limitation that cannot be improved upon. However, my other device is newer, and that's why it's able to give me a lot more download speed. So that's something you should note. Feel free to run speed tests on all your devices to know where the limitation is. The next thing I wanted to talk about is if you're, let's say, using your mobile device. So previously I was demonstrating this as a portable hotspot, but let's assume that this is connected to another hotspot or a Wi-Fi network as right now. So what I recommend you guys to do is, whether you are on PC or using your phone or tablet, you should install this app. It's called 1.1.1.1, and it's available on the Google Play Store. And all you have to do is, once you open it, go into your settings and make sure that it's selected to the first one, because I've noticed that the performance for the first one is better for me. You can feel free to try with the second one as well, but for me, the first one works. And then I'm gonna just enable it. And that's the last step you need to do to optimize your devices. If you have any questions regarding optimizing your hotspot, do let me know through comments. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you guys find it useful.